San Francisco State University, Finance 372, Prologis, Take Six in Action.
Hi there, my name is Stephanie Mahini, and we are presenting to you our recommendation to sell Prologis. And these are my teammates,
Jamie Lynn Williams,
Annie Lee.
So today we're going to cover the background, services, leadership, the SWOT analysis, ratios, valuations, recommendations, and references. Here's a little bit of background about Prologis. So it's a public company founded in 1984. They're members of the S&P 500. Here's some of their leaders. Hamid R. Mogadam is the CEO, and then these are some of his partners, senior partners. The products and services of Prologis are that they're a REIT. They own, operate, and develop some industrial distribution properties. Their culture, areas of focus are caring, teamwork, courage, and impact matter, and putting their people first. By doing this, it builds long-term relationships with their colleagues, customers, and investors. Here is a quick overview of our SWOT analysis. So they're a well-known company and a leader in the industry. Some areas where we found weaknesses that they have a non-diversified portfolio and a high debt level. The opportunities are to diversify their portfolio more and increase global trade for growth opportunities. And then potential threats are any financial crisis that will affect their development and a global economic crisis.
Yeah, so their industry overview. These are the top five industrial REITs that I was able to find. And as you can see, Prologis is the highest, $28.9 billion stock market cap. And so we did the financial ratios, and overall we found that they were, that Prologis was average. We compared theirs with DCT. And other ratios that we found, other ratios that we found were that they were mostly above average for the rest of the region.
Okay, so right here that we have a technical analysis right here that is the relative strength index of PLD is actually 51.31 in right in between right here. And then you can see that our support line is at 48. And if you see the resistance is almost at 54.86. And if you can see that the trend is over the long term, it indicates a long term upward. And it's slowly rising. So for our perpetuity model, our cap M is on the left. And then if you can see, we have the FFOPS from 2016 to 2018. We choose our growth rate of 6%, 7%, and 8%. So when we calculated our stock value for 6% is $46.67. And for 7% is $40, and then 8% is $35. And then we chose our intrinsic value of $46.67. And when we calculated it, the discount rate is around 14%. So for our board and growth model, we also have our cap M on our left side again. And the same FFOPS from earlier and growth rate. So when we calculated, we used the range of 1%, 2%, and 3%. So we chose the medium range of $56 from the Gordon growth model. And so our intrinsic value and the current price, we got about a premium of 3%. For our multiples approach, we use the REIT Watch multiples FFO, and then we predict the PE ratio of 18, 19, and 20. And so we use the stock value of 53.2 to be our intrinsic value, and our discount rate is about 2%.
For our discounted cash flows, we chose a growth rate of 15, 14, 13, 12, and 11 between 2018 and 2020. And we chose our rate as 6%, which gives us an intrinsic value of 51.97, which is a discount of 6% to the current stock.
And this is our net asset value. So we had a capitalization rate of 4%. What we chose to have our net asset value was at $57.
Okay, for our weight stock valuations, we chose three scenarios, and we chose that from all three. The $52 and $58 is the one that we will be selling. And so for intrinsic value is 52.58 from earlier, and then the current price is 54.35, and the discount rate is 3%. So we are gonna sell short, write calls, write 5 puts, and then we're gonna sell short, write calls, write puts, and then for indices, we're gonna write forwards, write futures, write calls on futures, 5 puts on futures.